Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2420, the frequency of a combination of two columns. Great question sent in from YouTube. Person has two columns. Area code is the numbers 1 to 36, month, the numbers 1 to 12. I created a fake data set here with 50,000 rows. They want a matrix that shows the combination, the count. Like how many times did code 5, month equal 5? All right, so across the top, we want the numbers 1 to 12. Type the number 1, hold down the control key, and drag over to 12. Down the left-hand side, type the number 1, drag the control key, and drag down to 36. This formula and the dollar signs are very important in this formula. We're going to count if everything in column A, all right, we dollar sign A, dollar sign 2, colon, dollar sign A, dollar sign, whatever your last row is equal to E12, and with the E12, a single dollar sign before the E, so that way, as we copy it to the right, it continues to point to E. Second criteria, look through column B, B2 to B50,001, again, with the four dollar signs, and see if it's equal to F11, this time, a single dollar sign before the 11. I'll copy that across, so Control C, Control V, double click the fill handle, and just to add a little bit of meaning, conditional formatting, color scales, the second color scale like that. The second method I think is far easier. Choose one cell in your data, insert pivot table on an existing worksheet. Let's go right here, click OK. In the pivot table, we want area code in the rows, month in the columns, and then check this out, month in the values. And that initially gives us sums, which is not what we want. But what we're going to do is click this first cell here under the 1-1 and go to field settings and change to account. Click OK. Now a couple of things to clean this up a little bit. First off, right click on the grand total heading, remove grand total. Same thing down here. Right click on the grand total heading, remove grand total. If you want the formatting, we should be able to apply that. Perfect. That, I think, is the easiest way. If you have Office 365, there's a third way. Three formulas. The formula right here is equal sequence 1, 12, gives us those 12 numbers. The formula here, equal sequence of 36, gives us those 36 numbers. And then a single formula here gives us the entire matrix. We don't need dollar signs because we're not copying the formula. Look through everything in column A, see if it's equal to AH12 hash. Look through everything in column B, see if it's equal to AI11 hash. That hash says, look at the whole array. We get the same answers as before. All right, three different ways to solve the problem. Check out my new book, Mr. Excel 2021. Definitely covers pivot tables. Click the I in the top right-hand corner. If you like these videos, please, down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments in the comments below. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.